Midnight recently made a video about how the Crucible breaks the Doom Eternal experience, and I kind of feel like making a response video, which I usually don't do. I'm not attacking Midnight. I like him. I like everyone in the Doom Eternal community. He and I spoke about this video topic before he did it, and it was an interesting little debate. So since he put out his thoughts, I'm gonna respond with mine. The general idea is that the Crucible is so powerful and plentiful in charges that it's ultimately antithetical to the combat design of Doom Eternal. I disagree. If we think about the new player's experience, and I'm talking about the majority of first-time players out there, people who are not high level or even close to decent, playing this game for the first time, they aren't ready for Nightmare. They aren't even ready for Ultraviolence most of the time. They are playing this game and having the struggle of their lives. Doom Eternal is insane. If we're talking about the Crucible breaking combat, then we're only talking about people that are playing the game several times and wanting to get better at it. Because the Crucible only starts to set the combat off balance with a good understanding of the game. Most people don't really understand Doom Eternal when they first get through it. It may be easy to get now, a year later, when new players have seen playthroughs and streams and speedruns and tutorials, but when this game came out, it was a nuclear bomb. Even a lot of our now best players weren't even trying to use the meat hook in their first playthrough, because that's normal. It's normal to play this game the first time and not understand concepts, or not learn them, or not experiment with them, to not understand weapon switching, to not get good with the flame belch, to not even notice the faltering system. You know what I did the first time I came up against the Marauder? I shot my plasma rifle into his shield repeatedly as I died over and over, like a fucking idiot. A lot of people fought him like an idiot, and barely got the kill in the Icon of Sin fight while suffering exhaustion. I died almost every time I tried to use the meat hook tactically. I spent an hour in some fights. And when you're having that kind of experience in a Doom game, weapons like the Crucible and the BFG feel incredible. They give the player a primal sense of satisfaction by letting them say, "Fuck you, I'm not dealing with you right now." That primal sense of satisfaction has been vital to the Doom experience ever since the original 1993 title and the Berserk power-up in God Mode. Quake went on to continue the tradition with the quad damage power-up that made you virtually unstoppable, a power-up that now finds itself in Doom 2016 and Doom Eternal. Since Doom Eternal is a much more cerebral game, where the satisfaction of combat comes from your wits, your reactions, your execution, your strategy, your resource management, a longer game that is much more chaotic and demanding, fewer of those incredible power-ups, having an extra super weapon like the Crucible to go side by side with the BFG helps provide the right amount of contrast to the game's action in the late game, and really satisfies part of our instincts that needs to be acknowledged. And we should be careful not to forget about the reality of the beginner's experience. Just because we've been playing this game for a year and it's all so simple and obvious to us now, but we should know that a new average player, probably slowly working their way up from Hurt Me Plenty to Nightmare on their second, third, or even fourth playthrough, there's no way they're even close to really being good at this game. They're still dying, they're still getting overwhelmed, they're still constantly improvising, they're still figuring out grenade setups. And I guarantee you they're not yet at the point of thinking they can just rely on Crucible charges to take care of all the big threats. Which takes me to my next two points. 1. The Crucible is not the only imbalanced weapon in the game. And 2. The Doom Eternal community shows that the Crucible isn't a problem. If the Crucible breaks Doom Eternal's combat, then so does the BFG, and so does the Unmaker when you use it correctly. Hell, I could take this further and say the same thing about lock-on rockets, chain gun shield, and SSG ballista. But I think saying that overlooks an important detail. I'll bet you that the vast majority of people that play Doom Eternal, that really play it, that work up to Nightmare, that learn the Doom Dance, that play the campaign 5 times or more, they love the game, and they love the rush they get from a challenge on a cerebral level, because Doom Eternal is designed to engage you that way. And if they're engaging in it on that level, then they're probably the kind of player that would stop using the Crucible just out of their own volition because they like keeping it interesting. There's lots of people who are into runs with no super weapons or custom rule sets and limitations. To talk about the super weapons breaking the game is to talk about a problem that doesn't really exist, because Doom Eternal players either play the game a handful of times and then stop, meaning the super weapons never would have hurt the game for them, or they stick with the game so they can find more challenge and thrills, and have stopped using the super weapons if they happen to find that they were hurting their experience now that they've gotten good at the game. And I'm sure there's plenty of really good players that use super weapons and still constantly engage with the philosophy of Doom Eternal's combat. Do I personally think it sucks to see that the most optimal speedrun strategies just trivialize things by memorizing spawns and BFG crucible charges? Yeah, kinda, but so what? If we didn't have those things in the game, I think Doom would be missing part of its soul. This is why I like seeing that power-ups are still in the game. There aren't many, and I'm sure that's because id Software would rather you engage in the awesome combat in these expertly crafted arenas instead of mashing a button to make everything dead. But we need power-ups. We need them to please the savage animal in all of us, high-level or casual player, and for the guy who's playing this as his first Doom game. It's why, even though I would personally like to see these things a little nerfed in a reasonable way, ultimately I don't have a problem with the power of lock-on rockets, energy shield, and SSG ballista. It's wonderful to have some powerful tools to help new players on their journey. They let you breathe a bit as you're getting better at movement and learning how grenades work and all that. Once you're pretty good at the game, you already know if you enjoy using the things you use, and you probably like the game enough to say, I feel this thing I'm using is too boring, so I'm gonna try playing differently. I don't think there's much in between here. I don't think super weapons negatively affect anyone's experience. They're very well integrated into the player's first few playthroughs, and then they become optional once the player has fallen in love with the combat system and has found their love for experimentation and challenge. And let me end with this. I have hundreds of hours in this game. I study it inside and out, and I'm still learning new things all the time. I'm 1,000 times the player I was back when Doom Eternal came out. I don't need super weapons. I don't use them much when I play. But you know what? When the Super Gore Nest Master level came out, and I was surrounded by 5 tyrants and 3 archviles, getting boxed in by carcasses, you bet your ass that when I felt victory slipping out of my hands, it felt great to pull out that Crucible or BFG and save myself from a brutal death. And it in no way interrupted the Doom dance I was engaged in. Alright. Yeah. That's what I think about that.